Hi there, I'm Chris, and welcome to TechEdge. Reliable and scalable storage solutions are vital for today's 24/7 data gathering, 4K video surveillance, and big data applications. Today, we're going to talk about hot swap storage drives, and most importantly, the key specifications you should look for. Hot swapping is the replacement of physical hardware, most commonly a hard drive, with a similar device while the computer is still running. You might want to hot swap a drive because it fails, fills up, or to introduce new data. We've seen many of our clients moving to hot swap hard drive management to help streamline the data storage, access, and archiving process. As with all technology, changing standards and hardware can have a far-reaching impact. And one fairly recent evolution in storage technology has the potential to cause headaches for those unprepared to make the necessary adjustments. But first, let's take a step back. Why would you want hot swap storage? Let's say your business runs the same software on all of the computers on your factory floor. In many manufacturing facilities, the most common point of hardware failure is hard disk drives. Airborne contaminants, extreme temperatures, and exposure to high levels of vibration can all contribute to hard drive failure, particularly if you're not utilizing a solid-state storage option. Without a hot swap option, you lose hours of time when a hard drive fails because you have to remove the mounted system, send it up to IT, wait for them to open it up, replace and test the hard drive, and then reinstall the system. If your system has a hot swap bay, you can keep multiple spare pre-configured hard drives on hand to swap in for the failed drive right on the manufacturing floor, saving an incredible amount of time and money. So hot swap storage is a great option, but here's where that key challenge we mentioned earlier presents itself. Not all storage drives are the same. 2.5-inch solid state drives, or SSDs, and hard disk drives, or HDDs, are available in different heights. Most of the drives here at OnLogic are either 7mm or 9.5mm tall. While there are hot swap bays built to accommodate different 2.5-inch form factor drive heights, bays designed for 9.5mm drives tend to be the most common. This means if your drive is not high enough to fill the entire hot swap bay, it may not line up correctly with the corresponding SATA connector, or Serial Advanced Technology Attachment connector, while the drive is in the bay. An additional complication that we see from time to time is that, depending on the system, the hot swap bay may need to be installed upside down to accommodate the other internal components. This doesn't present an issue as long as the storage drive being used fills the entire bay, but once again, if the drive is smaller than the bay, gravity will work against you to cause a disconnect between the SATA connector and the drive. If you remove and reinsert a hard drive into the hot swap bay and it's no longer detected by the system, you may have different size storage bays and storage drives. If possible, you might be able to simply flip over the system and insert the drive, but this isn't always a practical solution. So what do you do if your 7mm drive doesn't line up with the SATA connector in your hot swap bay? What you can do is use a 2.5mm spacer to fill the rest of the space. The spacer simply attaches to the top of the drive, makes the effective height of the drive 9.5mm. This ensures proper contact with the drive connector. It's a simple solution to what is ultimately a simple challenge, but if you didn't know there was different hot swap drive bays, you could easily chase the problem for a long time without ever landing on the fix. Because of the flexible nature of SATA drives, hot swappable HDDs or SSDs are a great option for a huge range of applications. But as with any hardware feature, it's important to understand the limitations and potential stumbling blocks. If you have questions about hot swap storage or suggestions for future topics, leave a comment below. If you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up and hit the subscribe button so you don't miss any upcoming videos. From the team here at OnLogic, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on TechEdge.